Hello friends, welcome to GYAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for this purpose we have started MCQ series of multiple subjects like Environment and Ecology, Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India. So in Environment and Ecology we are on the lecture number 31. Already 30 lectures have been covered, about which you can see in the playlist which I have specifically made for this purpose. So friends, are these series which we are running, we will be continuing these series till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So friends, we will also start other series as well, like geography, polity, economy, science and tech, current affairs, extra. So if you want to be confident in for your prelims exam and want to clear it with a great margin, then stay tuned with us. We will be continuing your prelim series, dedicated prelim series of different topics till 31st May. So let's start our discussion of environment and ecology, that is lecture number 31. So the first question is, consider the following statements about Kashmir strike. So friends, Kashmir strike, I think you might have listened about this animal a lot. So Kashmir strike, we have to consider the statements regarding this. It is the state animal of Jammu and Kashmir. Its only habitat is dense riverine forests. Third is, it is listed as critically endangered by IUCN. So friends, let me tell you that yes, it is state animal of Jammu and Kashmir. And also about third statement, it is also true that it is listed as critically endangered by the IUCN red list. That is the red list of International Union for Conservation of Nature. But friends, the second statement is not correct because it is also found in the mountains, in the high mountains of Kashmir. So which of the following options is correct? The D option is correct. That is 1 and 3 only. So 3 option is correct. It lives in dense riverine forests. It lives in high valleys. It is found in mountains of Kashmir Valley and also in the Chamba, northern Chamba district in Himachal Pradesh. So second statement is wrong. So friends, due to habitat destruction, overgrazing by domestic livestock and poaching, they are under threat. So Hangul, basically it is also known as Hangul. So it is the only Asiatic survivor or subspecies of European red deer. It was once widely distributed in the mountains of Kashmir, but now it is just limited to the Dachigam National Park that is located on the Jabalpur range in the outskirts of Srinagar. So friends, in prelims you might also be asked about the question that the Dachigam National Park is famous for. So it is famous for the Kashmiri stag or Hangul. So it is kind of only Asiatic survivor of or subspecies of European red deer. So this is all about your first question. Next is your second question. The lichens or lichens, as you may pronounce it, are not likely to be found in first cold regions, second tree barks, third sites with heavy air pollution due to sulfur dioxide. So friends, here the question is that lichens are not likely to be found in. So here the word not is attached. So please note this not word. So friends, let me tell you, they are found in cold regions, like in tundra regions they are found. And friends, you mostly see them on tree barks also. The kind of green colored cover you see on the trees. So it is a lichen. So it is they are also found in cold regions as well as on tree barks. So one and two statement is wrong. They are found there, and here we have been asked that where they are not likely to be found. But so as they are found in cold regions and tree barks, so one and two statements cannot be the answer. Now let's come to the third statement. Sites with heavy air pollution due to sulfur dioxide. So yes friends, lichens are not found the places where a high air pollution is there due to sulfur dioxide, because friends, basically these are found on the trees. They are found associated with trees, and they mostly rely for nutrients on air and do not rely for nutrients on soil. So if the air is polluted due to sulfur dioxide, then they will not likely to be found in such high pollution regions. So they are not the third statement is correct. So the only option left is C, that is third only. So this is the description about this. So the lichens and mosses can be found even in tundra regions. So one is incorrect, and they are most commonly found growing on barks of trees as a thin greenish white crust. So second is wrong too. So friends, the hardy lichens are also useful bioindicators for air pollution. So please note this, that they are useful bioindicators for air pollution, especially sulfur dioxide pollution, because where there is high sulfur dioxide pollution, they are not found there, because they drive their water and essential nutrients mainly from the atmosphere rather than from soil. So they are not likely to be found in such heavy air heavy air pollutant regions. So statement 3 is correct. Now let's come to the third question. Friends, here we have to consider the Cartagena protocol on biosafety and statements regarding it. So the first statement is, it seeks to promote genetically modified organisms in order to ensure biological diversity. Second is, it restricts countries from banning any imports of GMOs, that is genetically modified organisms. Third is, it acts as a supplement to the Convention on Biological Diversity. So friends, let me first tell you that there is a Convention on Biological Diversity, and you know about it, you might be knowing about it. So it has various supporting protocols to it, like Nagoya Protocol, and also Cartagena Protocol is a supplement to this Convention on Biological Diversity. The supplement to this Convention on Biological Diversity. So the third statement is correct. But now let's come to the question of what is Cartagena Protocol. So friends, here the first statement says that it seeks to promote genetically modified organisms in order to ensure biological diversity. Friends, this statement is wrong. The Cartagena Protocol on biosafety is its mandate is to, its purpose is to basically restrict the promotion and production of such genetically modified organisms that may threaten the original biodiversity. So those genetically modified organisms which threaten the natural biodiversity, its mandate, its function is to limit their production. So it does not promote genetic GMOs. So first statement is wrong, and also second statement is wrong, because it doesn't restrict countries from banning any imports of GMOs. So it gives the power to the concerned countries to ban any import of genetically modified organisms if those countries think that these GMOs may threaten their local biological diversity. So only the third statement is correct. So the correct option is B. So here the explanation is given that the Cartagena Protocol on Biosafety to the Convention on Biological Diversity, it is an international agreement on biosafety as a supplement to the Convention on Biological Diversity, effective since 2003. So statement 3 is correct. But friends, this protocol, biosafety protocol of Cartagena, it seeks to promote biological diversity and not genetically modified organisms. And while it seeks to promote biological diversity, how it seeks to do so? By preventing this biological diversity from the potential risks that are posed by the genetically modified organisms resulting from modern biotechnology. So statement 1 is incorrect. And also about second statement, I have told you that biosafety protocol makes clear that these products from new technology, they must be based on precautionary principles and also allow the developing nations to balance public health against economic benefits. So it will, for example, let countries ban imports of GMOs, and also if there is not enough scientific evidence that they will not threaten the local biodiversity, and if there is not enough scientific evidence for the safety of the product. So next is also, let me tell you friends, in India it is implemented by Ministry of Environment, Forests and Climate Change. So please note this statement, it is important from your prelims point of view. So this is all about your question. Next is fourth question. Consider the following statements about the Animal Welfare Board of India. First is, it is an advisory body established by an executive order. Second is, it is chaired by Prime Minister of India. Third is, the board provides financial assistance to recognized animal welfare organizations. So friends, let me tell you about Animal Welfare Board of India, that it is not established by an executive order. Friends, there is a special law that prevents the cruelty to animals, that is Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act 1960, in which there is a provision which provides for the creation of Animal Welfare Board of India. And as per this law, such Animal Welfare Board of India was established in 1962. So let me tell you that it is a statutory body. It is an advisory body, but it is not established by an executive order, but it is established by a particular statute, that is Prevention to Cruelty prevention of cruelty to animals act 1960 and it is a statutory advisory body. Next is, friends, second statement is it is chaired by the Prime Minister of India. Friends, it is wrong. Let me tell you that Animal Welfare Board of India is not chaired by Prime Minister. Rather, Prime Minister chairs the National Board for Wildlife. So there is a confusion. There might be, the students might get pricked in this question. So let me tell you that Prime Minister chairs National Wildlife Board of India and not Animal Welfare Board of India. Now next comes the third question. The board provides financial assistance to recognized animal welfare organizations. So yes, friends, third statement is correct. This board provides assistance to the recognized animal welfare organizations that are working for the welfare of animals. And also, friends, it give recognition to these organizations and oversee their functioning if these organizations meet the guidelines of the Animal Welfare Board of India. So only the third statement is correct. So the correct option is C option is the correct option. So already I have explained to you in detail that it is a statutory advisory body established in 1962 under the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act 1960. So one is incorrect. Also, National Board for Wildlife is chaired by PM and not the Animal Welfare Board of India. So it provides grant to the animal welfare organizations and also grants recognition to them if they meet their guidelines. So this is all about your fourth question. Friends, last question of the environment and ecology is related to dugong. Dugong, which is a marine, middle-sized marine mammal. You can see it in pic. In this image I have included. Friends, we have been asked here that it is declining day by day. So what is the reason of the decline of this mammal in oceans? First is loss and degradation of seagrass meadows. Second is fishing related fatalities. And third is coastal pollution. So let me tell you, friends, that all these reasons are responsible for its declining population. Loss and degradation of seagrass meadow. Because, friends, this mammal relies on seagrass as for its food. So if seagrass is getting hurt, then obviously this dugong will be kind of denied its food. So obviously it will witness decline. So also fishing related fatalities, friends, sometimes it gets caught in the fishing nets and it can't live for much time under the water because it has to come to the surface of the ocean. So if it is caught in the fishing net, then it will remain underwater and it will die. So this is also the reason. Also the coastal pollution is the reason, because, friends, as it is mostly found in the coastal regions, because seagrass meadows are found in the coastal regions. So this also exists in coastal regions, and now you know about this, that nowadays coastal pollution is on rise from the sewage, from the cities, and also from the industrial pollutants and other things. So all the statements are correct. That is 1, 2, 3. So D option is correct. So the dugong is largely dependent on seagrass communities for subsistence. So it is restricted to coastal habitats which support seagrass meadow. But you know that sewage, detergents, heavy metals, hypersaline water, herbicides and other agricultural runoffs and other waste products negatively affect seagrass meadows. So human activity also, like mining, trawling, dredging, land reclamation and boat propellers carrying, also they also increase sedimentation and smother the seagrass meadows. So obviously why? Because it prevents light from reaching these seagrass meadows. So obviously if seagrass meadow is affected, then certainly this dugong will also be affected. So it is a medium-sized marine mammal. Statement 2 is also correct, because entanglement in fishing nets cause many deaths because they can't remain for a long time in the under the water. So statement 3 is also correct, because as they live in coastal regions, as they are mostly found in coastal areas, and also as coastal pollution is increasing, so obviously they will be affected. Friends, other reasons are also there for their decline, because they are hunted for their meat and oil. So this is also the reason for decline. For example, in northern Australia, it has a great cultural significance and it is hunted. And also in Pacific Islands it is hunted. So this is all about your environmental lecture, friends. If you liked it, please like it, please share it with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel, and please don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can remain updated about our latest uploads which we do on YouTube, and you get all the updates which we upload on the YouTube. Lastly friends, if you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, you can WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968426481. So daily we are covering 5 questions and we will cover them till 31st May. So in a way we will be covering approximately 1100 questions if you go by calculation. And friends, and if you can if you are practicing 1100 questions of this topic, then you can imagine that how much confident you can be about environment and ecology in your exam, in your prelims exam. So friends, for the purpose of our affordability and for the purpose of our motivation and for the purpose of your affordability, we have kept the minimum subscription fee for it, that is ₹50. So friends, it is a single time payment. You have to pay just ₹50 and you will be subscribing to all the PDFs of these MCQ series of environment till 31st May. That means you will be getting 1100 questions in just ₹50. It is a single time payment. So friends, in ₹50 you will get all the PDFs till 31st May. So there are other courses like environment, medieval India, modern India, ancient India, for which the subscription fee is different. And let me explain to you our initiatives that we are currently running on YouTube, that there are other initiatives of us like environment. For this, for we have kept the subscription charges of ₹50. For ancient India it is 100, for medieval India it is 100, for modern India it is 100. So total amounts to ₹350. So if you want to subscribe to them in a package form, then friends, we are offering you a discount of ₹75 and you will be subscribing to them in just ₹275. So approximately friends, as I have told you, that daily we are covering 5 questions. Then if you go by calculation, then of each topic we will be covering 1100 questions till 31st May. So if you multiply it by 4 topics, then the amount comes is 4400. That means you will be getting 4400 questions in just ₹275. So it is a very minimum amount that we have kept for the purpose of your affordability, and also we have to sustain ourselves, and that's why we have kept this fee for our motivation friends. So if you want to motivate us so that we can help you, then you can subscribe to these initiatives. And for subscribing, the number, WhatsApp number is this. You can WhatsApp us on this number, that is 8968426481. So lastly friends, let me tell you that why it is important to subscribe to these PDFs. Because friends, at the end of the day, you will not have enough time to see 20 to 25 minute long videos to revise the basic concepts, and also you can't be able to read the bulky books at that time for the revision purposes, because it will be an utter wastage of time, because at that time you will have to revise multiple topics and not only the one topic like environment or history or polity or geography. You will have to revise all these topics, including current affairs, science and tech, and art and culture, and others as well, economy as well. So for that purpose you must have some kind of notes in the PDF format. You must have some kind of notes in the MCQ format, so that you can revise all the basic concepts quickly and go into the exam hall confidently, so that you can clear the exam with a great margin. So if you want to be confident in your exam hall and want to clear the prelims of 2019, you can WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968426481, for subscribing to these PDFs. So thank you friends. Lastly friends, let me tell you that we have a Telegram channel also, for the link of which I have provided in the description box, and you can join our Telegram channel by checking the link in the description box. Those who know how to join, it is good, and those who don't know, let me tell you that you can join my Telegram channel by downloading an app called eSandesh, which is available on Google App Store as well as on Google Play Store as well as on Apple App Store. So it is totally free of cost app. You can download it, and when you will download it, you will encounter here a search box. You will see here a search box, and just you have to do what you have to do is the copy and paste the link of my Telegram channel here, and when you will paste the link of my channel here, you will get to my channel and then you can join it. So it is totally free of cost, and friends, there is no cost of joining the Telegram channel. So it is totally free of cost facility. All the initiatives that we are running on different platforms, these are posted on on our Telegram channel. So if you want to remain stay tuned with us, you can join our Telegram channel. Thank you friends. Thank